All right, welcome. It's Illusion of Gaia time. Part four, I think? Let's start the journey. So we are in the Sky Garden over the Nazca Lines. This is the next dungeon. I think that the second, which we'll call it, Mystic Statue is here. So, clockwise order. So, we start over here. What's this? Nothing, I guess. Okay, that's nothing. So it says clockwise order. With the reason being that I think the enemies in, get gradually more difficult. Oh, and then there's that. So you can kind of see the walkways that are on the other side. This is kind of a neat area because it has kind of like a what's the word I'm looking for? It has a two-sided geometry with gravity getting switched out. We got enemies here. These guys are easy to lose a lot of hit points fighting because they have abilities that you might think that you can hit them fast enough to block, to avoid having to block them, but just gonna play it a little safe. And then things get a little heavy here. So there's two red jewels in this area. They're both in treasure chests, according to my... There's one. They're both in treasure chests, according to my guide, so we don't have a whole lot of secret stuff to look for this time. We just gotta kind of make sure that we... clear that. That's kind of neat, how they reverse the sprite and everything. And the enemies are different. And those guys do a slightly different... Ooh! It still hit me! That's interesting. So these guys move a little faster, and the, their parts drop in a different pattern. We can't reach them yet. Let's just take a quick glance around. Make sure I'm not missing anything. Oh, these are interesting. Ooh. So I'm taking a lot of damage here. Oh, we got a couple hit points. That'll help. Four more enemies, all of them over here. That's just the... Oh, cool! Do you see the faces in the explosions? That's the thing. So is this just where I came from? Yeah, it is. Okay. So we saw two places that we can flip back over one more time. We're gonna have to check them both out, because I'm pretty sure that one of them leads to a treasure chest and one of them leads to, like, finishing the area or something. But they're both over here, so this shouldn't be too bad. Oh, treasure chest, first one! An herb. If you get on those guys real fast, you can take them out before they can shoot their arms out, but it's kind of a crapshoot. Alright, let's check this out. One more enemy, and we're treasure chest. And heart. Hit points. Alright. Then we got this guy. Alright, crystal ball number one. Watch out for that sword. There's an enemy kind of like that in Symphony of the Night. Ooh, Symphony of the Night. I could play that. Alright, so this area is clear, and the backside of this area is clear as well. So we're ready to move on to the next space. Sky Garden feels big, but it's actually not that bad. So you'll see that each crystal ball moves one platform. We're going to save real quick. So you see that area, the first one, was actually decently challenging. I took a bit of damage, mostly because I was being careless, but... So this is kind of cool. There's actually a special animation for Will. I like that. That's a great animation. And it's totally unnecessary, but they added it there just to make it look cool. I mean, like, that could have just been a space for you to walk across. But instead, Will has to kind of do that thing where he walks carefully, back pressed up against the wall. It's pretty cool. That's interesting. See, that guy doesn't count as an enemy. I think he respawns. Okay. There we go. Okay, so the sword's down. He turns silver again, and I can move him out of the way. That lets me jump over here. Also, there's no treasure chests here, so that means that the thing that we're looking for, the crystal ball, must be on the backside. Oof. Walked right into that one. Okay, so here's an interesting one. You can barely tell, but there's actually a door behind him, which leads to here. And I think this gets us... Yes! Freedan. Alright, let's check this out. Okay, so they move that out of the way so we don't get trapped in the room. Alright. That clears... Well, it doesn't clear the area, but this clears the areas that we can reach at this point. So Frida has a little extra defense, which is nice, and I'm taking hits carelessly because I'm not thinking about this, right? And he's shooting beams at me, and I'm taking hits for no really compelling reason. But that's alright. We can get a recharge soon. I can always go back to the place where I turned into Frida for a recharge. Ooh! That's hopefully something. See, the cool thing about the magic jewel system in this game, as compared to Soul Blazer, is that the stuff all happens in media res, so to speak. There's no, like, going back to the screen to see the thing come out and show up and all that stuff. Oh boy. Two guys there. Oh, I'm taking damage again. See, the interesting thing is they can shoot those beams from off-screen a little bit. So it's easy, relatively easy, to get hit by those when you're not watching. And this is probably the crystal ball. And it opens up a path, gives us a hit point. Oh, and these things are free to move now. Which is, I guess, not that bad. So we've cleared the you can even see the ladder. That kind of attention to detail is really nice. Like, you don't even have to notice it, but it's there. If you're just willing to look. And then this area is clear too. So we just need to make our way back. So... let's see, we're about halfway done. About 13 minutes in. I'll say we'll probably finish the Sky Garden today, and then we'll call it. Sounds like a reasonable place to go today. Can Frida do this? Oh, he can. Nice. So we're going to stick around as Frieden because he just has better defense, better attack, and longer range. He's better at overall combat, so let's drop this off. There we go. And then just do a quick save. The music in the area is pretty cool too, very heroic sounding. I kind of wish the meaty drums were a little bit better. Oh yeah, this area has a bit of a puzzle element to it. You see those posts, they can be flipped up and down. Wow. And there's a treasure chest here. Let's see, where does this lead? Thank you. didn't take damage there. Was it because I was parrying? That's interesting. Okay. We're going to try to clear as much of this area as we can before I head up to the backside. But this looks like something that I'm going to need Will for. And I can't get in either direction as Freedan without... Yeah, so that's like a throughway. So, down we go. Okay. One chest, 7 enemies, and a force thing. Red Jewel, that's number 2. So that clears this area as far as Red Jewels go. Oh, that's interesting. I didn't know that, parrying... Yeah. Okay, we got this. Oh, my control went a little wonky. And this doesn't actually help me, does it? How am I gonna get down there? Huh, that's interesting. Alright, let's hit this. Oh, that doesn't help either. Interesting. Okay, I kind of thought that that would let me do something useful, but I guess not. We're gonna have to go back over to this side. And what happened is, I think this opens up. Yep. Staircase. Got those two. 4 more down here. That opens this up. Oh. Clears this area. Get some additional defense. There's a thing for us to use. Here's this. There's a tricks to this. Yeah, I can't get there as Freedan. The trick is that I need to be Will. But... Gonna have to think this one through a little bit, huh? Okay, so that flipped a few things. It hasn't flipped this yet. These are still up, so we gotta figure out how to get those down, because they're gonna be in our way. We can go this way, and we can use Will's Psycho Dash to knock these out. But there's still a treasure. Well, that's the treasure chest, probably with the crystal ball in it. There, obviously. So you'll notice that the Psycho Dash does decent damage. Not quite as good as Dark Friar, but decent. sometimes you can block that, and sometimes you can't. I'm not quite sure the reason. So far, I'm 2 for 4. I've blocked it twice, and I've gotten hit by it twice. Alright. One enemy left. We can do this. This guy. Ooh, gotta be careful there. Alright, strength up. Good. And there's no treasure chest here. This tile makes a sound when you step on it. So we're gonna have to... There we go. And if you... Yep. Have any guess at all, that does that. There's no enemies or treasure chests here left, so we're just gonna... hop back over to the other side. Oh. Whatever. I'd worry more about the damage if I wasn't just gonna get recharged in the next minute. Okay. So, as you can guess, we have moved those sets of pillars down. Now all Will has to do is that. Way back. This way. Awesome. I remember when I was a kid, this dungeon was grueling. Or at least it felt that way. It feels longer than it is. I already said that, but it is true. Three down, one to go. Alright. Those ones you can definitely block. Now this is interesting, because this looks like it's a one-way move. Or it could be. It certainly could be. Oh. Why do they gotta be tricky? There's a trick there. There's a trick here, and then there's a trick over here. In that, you gotta kinda be ready for it. And this leads over here. 16 enemies, no treasure chests. Whoa. That was a little close. These guys are a little fast. Oh, dang it. Okay. This leads over here. That's actually literally no help. Yeah, that's a one-way path. So we're gonna have to head the other way. Careful. Fortunately, my defense has gone up pretty well, so... Alright, 6 enemies left in this area. Including 2 up there, what the heck? I missed something? Maybe. Let's just give it a quick check. Yeah, I must have missed some enemies. Run through the little fireball thing, but it's probably best not to tempt fate. I suppose if I was better at recognizing its movement pattern, I'd be able to do that, but oh well. I'm not good, very good at that. Okay. Phew! Dark space. Frieden again? Way too much damage. Alright. Cleared this area. Pretty darn close to clearing this one. 7 enemies. See that one. So, I don't know what that's there for, other than to be irritating. Okay. So we need to think a little bit here. There's 2 treasure chests and 4 enemies. Now, let's just think for a minute here. If I hop here, I go over this away. What do we see over here? We're gonna try to solve this puzzle with intelligence. Which I may not have, but we'll try it. There is this space on the bottom, which doesn't have a path over to this side. And then there's this, which is... Oh, I actually haven't gone this way. Well, that's much easier. And it looks like. That's interesting. So it looks like we need to do both, honestly. So we'll just go top to bottom, I guess. Entirely sure why they would set up a puzzle like that, but so be it. Oop. There's an herb. So the one with the statue is the one with the crystal ball, almost certainly. And we've cleared out the enemies from both sides, and once we get that last treasure chest, we will be done. Ready? Hop! Yeah. Just gotta get this guy out of the way. Alright. We are finished. As soon as I figure out the way back. I think it's just this, isn't it? Oh, not quite, not quite. Because I can't make it up there. Frieden looks pretty cool when he's running. A little more dignified than Will. Who, as we have already confirmed, looks shabby. And here we go! Hop, hop, and done. Also send this out. So you notice we've already got, what, 7 herbs? And I've used 1. So we've gotten... There's not an unlimited supply of herbs in the game. There's only, like, 12 or something like that. I forget exactly the number. But this is it. The end of the Sky Garden. They don't say anything new. Pretty sure. You have to wonder why floating heads need a mode of transportation. They're floating heads. Immortal floating heads. Oh wow, you see that damage? So we're gonna try to use the Dark Friar mostly. The bosses all get the maximum number of possible hit points. Oh boy. Without using an herb. That was very abrupt. Can Will survive this fall? Frieden's like, alright, I'm out, peace. And Will's like, no, but I can't survive this fall. Oh, here we go. Strange noise fills the air around you. Yeah, no kidding! Really? Airplane? Please make it, please make it. Ah. Okay. We saved him, and he only broke both of his legs and one of his arms. The shape of Cygnus is the same as the shape of Mu. To the ocean! Mode 7. Well, at least he also developed parachutes. Something missing. Nobody's perfect, including Neil. Especially Neil. Huge palace. With some sort of limited amnesia. Is everyone safe? Oh, there's enemies here. And you can't hurt them. Well, they immediately throw you into an even bigger dungeon. And we are going to work on that next time. So, thank you for watching, and later!